Assalamualaikum, dear students. Today we are learning class 9 science biology. This video is related to some of the doubts of the students. Many of the students have the doubts in the protoplasm and cytoplasm. Yes, and another student was asking me about the protoplasm, vacuoles and plastid. So I had given the all this 4 types of organelles which are present into the cell in this video, that is protoplasm, cytoplasm, plastid and vacuole. So let's begin with dear students. Okay, so first is protoplasm and cytoplasm. Those who having still the confusion that either the protoplasm and cytoplasm is the same thing or protoplasm and cytoplasm is a different thing, this is this slide might be give you a proper idea about that. You can see here in this image that dear students, that cytoplasm is the surrounding part of the nucleus, right? You can see over here, this is the surrounding part of the nucleus. Okay, that is called as cytoplasm, in which all the cell organelles are present. The cell organelles that are mitochondria mitochondria, Golgi body, endoplasmic reticulum, all that organelles are present into the cytoplasm, whereas the nucleus is the main center part of the cell. We can also say that nucleus is the brain of the cell. Both combined, that cytoplasm and nucleus both combined is called as a protoplasm. Protoplasm is actually a living matter. Let's see about the cytoplasm first. What is cytoplasm? The first thing is that the cytoplasm is watery gel-like substance found inside all the cells. Of course, that is a very basic thing that we all know, dear students, that one cell comprises 3 things. First is plasma membrane, second is nucleus, and third is cytoplasm. All cells having these 3 things: plasma membrane, nucleus and cytoplasm. So what is the function of cytoplasm? The cytoplasm acts like a salt water swimming pool for the other cell parts. Even though cytoplasm is one of the simplest part of the cell, without it nearly all the other parts would not be able to move freely through the cell. Might be whatever is written over here that will not to be clear to you. That is why I'm giving you a very common example, dear students. This is the image and I want to explain you about that, what is cytoplasm. You can see over here the endoplasmic reticulum. This is the endoplasmic reticulum, dear students. Okay, this is the endoplasmic reticulum. This is the Golgi body, mitochondria. So many organelles are present. So these organelles are present into the cytoplasm. Though I want to give you a very common example of it. Okay, first of all, why do we need cytoplasm? So think about a bathtub. You all have seen a bathtub full of toys, right, dear students? So imagine when the bathtub does not have any water in it, all the toys are laying at the bottom of the tub. Yes, of course. But when you add water, the toys can float or move around in the water. Yes, in the same way, the water, as the water is present inside the bathtub and the toy starts to floating, the same way cytoplasm provides a structure for the cell like the water does for the toys in the tub. You can also think of cytoplasm like a water in a water balloon. Of course, you all are familiar with this water balloon. You are playing with it, dear students. If imagine without the water, the balloon would not have a particular shape, right? It would just be flat. So this is just like your cells without cytoplasm. Cytoplasm provides a structure to float different organelles in the cell. So I hope cytoplasm is clear to you, dear students. Now further moving with the protoplasm. Protoplasm is a mixture of small molecules such as ions, monosaccharides, amino acids and macromolecules such as proteins, polysaccharides, lipids, etc. Dear students, whatever the ions I had discussed over here, all these ions are living. They are really very needed to our cell, to our body. Protein is also very important to our body. Monosaccharides, amino acids. So remember, all these ions, all this living part is present where? In protoplasm. Whereas what is cytoplasm? Cytoplasm is only just providing jelly-like substance to float different organelles. You can see here in this image, dear students, that cell membrane, which is also called as plasma membrane. Inside the cell membrane, nucleus is present, the black dot you can see over here, and the bluish part is called as a cytoplasm. So nucleus is also living matter because it has DNA, it is the control center of the cell. The cytoplasm, which is liquid surrounding the nucleus, both nucleus and cytoplasm both comprising the protoplasm. Yes, dear students. That protoplasm comprises the living part of the cell. It includes what? It includes cytoplasm, nucleus, and other organelles. So I hope those who are having the doubt between cytoplasm and protoplasm, it clear here, over here. Okay, now moving with the next doubt, that is plastid. Yes, plastid. Before studying plastid, I want to ask one question to you, dear students. Did you ever wonder that how plants breathe, drink, eat, and grow? Have you ever wondered? For example, we are breathing from our nose, from our lungs. For drinking and eating, we use our mouth and we are growing. But have you ever wondered how plants breathe, drink, eat, and grow? Of course, they carry out all these functions just like us, but in different ways. And one category of specialized organelle that plants use in order to survive is plastid. Getting to your student, what is plastid actually? Plastid are double membrane bound organelles found inside plants and some algae, which are primarily responsible for activities related to making and storing food. And many plastid are photosynthetic, but not all the plastids are photosynthetic. But for 9th standard, there are so many different kind of plastids are there. But for the main plastid is chloroplast. Chloroplast, why? Because chloroplast is present in all the vegetation, in all the plants, and it doing the process of photosynthesis. And photosynthesis is very requiredly, very necessarily process in plants. So that is why we have to learn about the chloroplast over here. Or I will give you the another image to understand plastid verily. That plastid is mainly of two types, that is chromoplast and leucoplast. Chromo means color and leuco means white. So chromoplast consists of colored plastid in that green, the pigment of green, it is known as chloroplast. Red and orange, these are also the pigments present into the plants. We have seen many different fruits of different colors, many different flowers or different colors. So these different colors comes from these different pigments from different plastids. And leucoplast is white or colorless plastid. So I hope plastid is also clear to you, dear students. Now further, we are moving with our next topic, that is vacuole. Okay, so before starting vacuole, I want to ask another question to you, that whenever your room is messy, whenever your house is messy by you, your mom or anybody else into your home, you are asked to you clean up your room, right? So where do you put all of your clothes and toys or whatever the mess up you have done? In a closet, in a dresser, in a box, in a cupboard, right? Means you need anything to put your all the things. For example, if you want to put your clothes, you need a cupboard. So in a same way, a cell also need one kind of place to that keep that things too. So that is the job of a vacuole. That a vacuole is a storage area for the cell. It can store food, water, or anything else a cell may need to survive. Getting, dear students, so a vacuole looks like a lot like a water balloon. There's a thin outer layer called a membrane holding everything in it. Vacuoles collect and hold onto all sorts of material for a cell, including food and water. Sometimes a vacuole holds waste or bad things as well. Getting, dear students, in this image you can two types of vacuoles you can see over here. One is plant vacuole and another is an animal vacuole. So you can see over here that plant having a large amount, a big vacuole, the size is bigger in plant vacuole, whereas in animal vacuole the size of the vacuole is very much less. Getting, so this is the vacuole. Definitely the vacuole is present in both the cells, in plant cells also and in animal cells also, but the size is different. Also, the vacuole is of three types. The first, in plant cells, central vacuole usually filled with the water and other substances which are required for the plant. Second, in animal cell, the food vacuole. Many times this example comes in front of you, dear students, that how amoeba can take its food, that amoeba creates pseudopodia, make a food vacuole, engulf it. So that is the food vacuole by the in animal cells. Getting that several small food particles come into the form of the vacuole, engulfed by it, then used for digestion, secretion and waste. And the third type of vacuole is contractile vacuole that pumps out excess water and also the pumps out excess some waste materials from the cell. You can see over here, dear students, the arrow will be shown over here you too. It is expansion and contraction occurs. This continuation process of expansion and contraction, will remove out the whatever the waste material present inside the cell, it remove out the cell. So I hope, dear students, you are now clear with the protoplasm, cytoplasm, plastids and vacuole.